so happy to talk to you. Yeah.
Yeah, sir. Yeah, sir. Let me introduce you by myself first, sir. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm a Myomin Thai from Myanmar, and I'm an English learner, and I'm a learning and I'm a sharing at the same time. So, you know, I have been watching your video on internet. So all of your video are really brilliant. I really like that video.
Wow,
because
you
have a you have a very good mindset, and you are really kind. You know, you interview, you make a lot of interview to other foreigner, yeah. Just like Ukrainian. You know, I saw one video that you have been making, you know, interview with Ukrainian girl. It's really sweet.
Yes, yeah.
Yeah, wow, I really like that.
Have you seen that? Have you seen that?
Yeah, I already seen that.
Okay.
I really like that.
Thank
video.
You.
And also, you know, all of your video admire you a lot, inspire me a lot, and I really like your personality a lot. That's why I decided to make interview with you. Yeah.
Wow, that's amazing. So where do you live in Myanmar?
Yeah, I live in Myanmar.
So where in which city?
Yeah, Yangon. Yangon. Yangon is the capital city of our Myanmar. Yangon.
Yangon.
Yeah,
in my country, so we pronounce like Yangon, some
Yangon.
Kind of.
Yeah, Yangon. Yeah, most people they mispronounce our country.
Wow,
yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, to be honest, I'm really beginner level of English, and I started learning English last year, 31st October 2019.
That's amazing. That's amazing. I understand you all.
Yeah. Yeah, and also, you know, just like. No, I admire you a lot because you know,
wow.
The way that you were doing some kind of video is amazing, and I learned a lot of English from your video. That's why I really want to say thank you first before I introduce myself. Yeah.
Wow, yes, thank you as well. Yes. You've been watching my video, okay.
Oh yeah. And also, you know, I learned something, you know, in Lao a little bit, just like Sabadi, right? Sabadi.
Wow, thank you. Sabadi. How to say Sabadi in your language?
Mingalaba. Mingalaba.
Mingalaba?
Yeah, Mingalaba.
Wow, okay, Mingalaba.
Yeah. So today, can I ask you some question? Just like five questions I decided to ask you for other English learner, because I'm not English teacher. I'm also a teacher, but I'm teaching accounting, economics, business study, and also LCCI. I'm teaching those kind of finance subject, but in my school, I also need to speak in English. So I'm trying to improve my spoken language within 1 year. So now I have been learning my English by myself through listening to some kind of podcast and also your video. Your
video that's amazing.
Helped me a lot to improve my spoken language because you always use some kind of, you know, simple and very easy to understand word. That made me, you know, happy, and that made me satisfied when I was watching your video. That's why, yeah.
Wow. Okay, let's start.
Sir, can you, you know, introduce me a little bit about yourself?
Wow, sure. Okay. So hi everybody. So my first name is Sang Kham. My family name is Koma Sang, but please just call me Sang for short. So I'm here, I'm Laos, so I'm living in Vientiane, which is the capital city of Laos. And I am an English tutor, and I doing a lot of English video that to help the people who following me to improve their English. So that's who am I. Okay?
Very nice. Very nice, sir. Very nice. I really love that, you know, person. Okay.
Thank you.
Now, I was so, you know, I don't know why. Before I start this, you know, interview, I feel it's totally okay. But now I feel a little bit, you know, nervous or excited. I don't know why. You know.
No, your English is pretty good. Okay, I understand you everything you said. Okay.
Oh my God! Thank you so much, sir. You know, to be honest, you know, I started my English learning very seriously last year. So this is only 1 year and 3 months, you know.
Wow, that's amazing.
Yeah.
A very short period of time you can do that, okay?
Yeah, sir. Okay, so sir, the first question is like, you know, exposure and effort is really important to improve our spoken language. So what is your opinion on that? Yes, sir.
Do you mind repeat your question again?
Oh yes, sir. Just like, you know, in our country, just like international student, they are attending an international school. So they have been, you know, speaking in English all the time in their school, and they keep in touch with English. So they can speak English very well without learning, you know, without learning with effort. So they can speak English very well. But In our country, just like normal people, they cannot attend in international school. They just attend in government school. So they cannot speak English very well. Even if they were learning English for maybe 5 years or 3 years or 2 years, like this kind of, you know, learning, but they really can't speak English properly. So can you help me, you know, just like, can you give me some kind of advice, just like exposure and effort is really important to improve our spoken language. So what is your opinion on that? Yes.
So those people who are cannot speak English, like who are learning at the like government school, yeah, they don't have chance to learn English with English native speaker.
Yeah.
Don't worry. You can learn English by yourself. So my recommendation is, first you have to love English. You have to set your goal. Yeah. After that, you have to like listen to English in every day. I mean, just listen to it. Even you don't understand what is it mean, you have to listen every day.
Yeah.
You should listen to the English native speaker. Don't listen to some type of and like Americans or British. So if you like it, both is okay. So don't try to copy it. A specific accent that you can call whatever it's make you understand, and you can understand it easy. Yes. The most important thing is you have to do it every day, constantly. And you have also the best way to improve your pronunciation or listening skill, I guess, beside listen to YouTube video, at least 1 hour, I guess, 1 or 2 hours, and do it every day.
Yes.
And you have to read a lot of English book that written by the English native speaker, especially the book that written by the Oxford University or Cambridge University. So those universities are the top university in the world.
Yes.
So they write the book. It's really easy to understand, and you can choose start from the beginner and go to higher and higher. And for your pronunciation, I recommend that you should learn the IPA first. IPA, you can go to YouTube, just type the IPA in English.
International Phonetic Alphabet.
Is the IPA. So that can help you to speak like correct English, especially the like stress syllable or the ending sound. That's really important in English. And after that, you have to, I mean, read. After you read a lot, so you try to speak out. Like, don't panic to make any mistake, because English is not our mother tongue, so we can.
Yeah.
Like, even English native speaker, they still make a lot of mistake, like in grammar, in some kind of. So for us, so we don't care about grammar. So so as long as the other people can understand us, that's really okay. So you don't be shy, just speak out. If other people correct your English, so thanks to them. If they don't understand, try to explain them how to express yourself better. That is really important. And I guess that it's not you can learn something like very quickly. You can learn just 2 or 3 months that you can speak English well. It's not that easy.
Yes.
Maybe it would take you about a year to improve your English skill. That's because for me myself, so I teach myself. I mean, self-taught. So I don't have to go to the school. I just read a lot of book and listen to a lot of YouTube video. Like my favorite channel might be like the BBC Learning English. News and Sky News, and also like another British YouTuber like ETJ English.
Oh yeah,
ETJ English and Papa Teach Me and English with Lucy and
Lucy.
A lot. I mean, I watch a lot of, and the previous, I mean, in the last 7 years, because I have been living in Vietnam for 7 years and I learned English in there. So currently I'm go back to my hometown and living here and teach a little bit English for my student. Okay, so that's all my recommendation. Okay, just do it now, so don't wait for tomorrow.
Okay, sir, it's really really nice, you know, amazing answer for my question. So I really like your answer. Okay, thank you, sir. So so I really like your answer, because you know, I asked you that, like exposure and effort. So you have been, you know, giving the specific answer related with exposure and effort only in one answer.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. So the second question is just like, Most of the English learners, they don't have specific goal and target when they were learning English. That's why they never succeed. I realized that thing. So how about your opinion on that? What kind of suggestion do you really want to give those kind of people?
Yes, so it means to have your goal. And I think that you just think, you just imagine that your goal is to learn English for watching the movie, or to learn English to communicate with the other people, or to have like a lot, I mean, to sell things or to do business with the foreigners or other people who cannot speak your own language, or just get some kind of try to make yourself. I mean, you have to love it first. If you love it, you can do it by your heart, so you can learn better.
Yeah.
So how to make yourself love English is, I guess, try to, like, if you have the specific, like, the your idol, some kind of, like, you love Justin Bieber or Taylor Swift, or who are, yeah, those, yeah, like, celebrity, like, British or American celebrity, and try to watch the interview of them and try to watch their lifestyle, or then, like, you will love their language, I guess, and try to think about your future. So if you could speak English, so what would you benefit in your life? You could earn a lot of money, or you could work an international company, or you could do some kind of that you want to do if you could speak English. So let's try to think like that. So it's if you love that, it's easy. So if you don't love, it's difficult to learn.
Exactly. Yeah, okay. Yeah. So how can I say, if we have no chance to do the job that we love, we have to try to love the job that we do.
That's true.
Great. Okay, number three question is just like if we have, you know, normal routine that, you know, connected with English, that is, you know, English habit, if we have those kind of English habit in our daily life, so our English will be improving day by day, just later by later. So how can we create our English habit in our life, sir?
Wow, that is very good question, because I'm using that method currently.
Yeah.
First of all, try to think in English. So instead of thinking in your own language, like, yeah, example, after work, you usually think like, what I'm gonna eat tonight, and tomorrow what I'm gonna do, and what I'm gonna do after work. Some kind of, you have to think in English. Wow. So that's to make your environment so, like, you speak English by yourself 24 hours, okay?
Yeah.
Because before you speak out in your own language, you have to think in English first. And so that makes you can practice English all the time. That's very useful method that I'm using currently and since the past and until now.
Yes.
Because I have been learning three different languages, like, before, because English is my fourth language. Because,
oh,
yeah, the first is my mother tongue. We learned very like small group of people in Laos. And the second language is Lao. Yeah. The third language is Thai. Maybe. Yeah. The fourth language is Vietnamese. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. English is considered my fifth language. Is English.
Oh my! You are such a breathtaking. You are such a mind blowing person. Yeah. Oh my God.
Yeah. Amazing. So in terms of that, you know, in each language that I master, so I try the same method that I try to think in their own language.
Wow.
Like when I learn Vietnamese, I try to think in Vietnamese, and then I go to English, I try to think in English, and currently I'm thinking in English before I speak out to my own language. That's very useful, no doubt. Yeah, you can use that, very useful, and practice every day for yourself. Like your smartphone and some kind of your computer, you have to change the language to English. So like when your friends or your family take you or mention you in the comments, so it like you got the notification in English, so that remind you every time.
That's, yeah, really, that really, yeah, I believe that method, because I'm also using that method, you know, it's really good for me.
Yeah, yeah, that's sir. Cool.
Thank you, sir. Yeah, I have another question, sir. Yeah.
Yeah, sure.
That is for, you know, most of the beginner English level learner. So they really don't know to learn English and how they can start and what kind of thing they should learn, what kind of thing they shouldn't learn, and those kind of feelings they have. That's why, you know, they they cannot start their, how can I say, English learning journey, English learning process. They really cannot start. So do you have any other suggestion for those kind of, you know, English learner, beginner level English learner?
Sure. So I guess that, so just imagine, so I'm asking you back question, like before you can speak your own language, how you did it. First thing, you listen to your father or mother talk, right?
Exactly.
The second thing is, after you listen to them, you try to copy them, how they said the word, some kind of. So yes. After that, you go to school, you learn to write, you learn to read, right? So English is similar. That's I use the method is by listening first, listening on the YouTube video, listening to English native speaker. So at the same time of you are listening, try to translate or try to check the meaning of the words in your own language. And when after you finish your first time listening, then try to pick the English book and read. You can practice your listening skill at the same time you are reading, and you can learn the new vocabulary and to learn how to use the vocabulary. So when you are reading as well, so just that is easy. Just first is listening, then try to try to copy the words that the words or phrases or the sentences that how the people are saying. First is you have to like memorize a very similar type of phrases like hello, how are you, what's your name, some kind of.
Yes.
Yeah, after that you listen to make yourself familiar with the accent or familiar with English, that try to read and try to, I mean, when you are listening, you have to learn to copy that accent at the same time, right? And yeah. The words, which word they use in each situation that you learn at the same time. Yeah, so
thank
after
you so
that
much.
You can just speak out to the foreigners or someone who can speak English, can try to speak with them. If you have no friend, you can practice on some kind of apps like they got Siri or some kind of some kind of dictionary that you can practice with them, even Google, and you can you tell the Siri to do what, and if it can understand you, that means your accent is correctly. Yeah, it's correct, so he can understand you. Let's try that way. Yeah.
Actually, rather than being a teacher, you should be a English advisor. You know.
Yeah. I'm not that good. Okay, I'm trying.
No. Don't say like that, because you know, for me, you are such as really amazing person. Because this interview program is the first Thai interview program for me, because I have never done anything like this kind of interview before.
That's amazing.
Yeah, you are the first, how can I say, interviewee for me in my life. Yeah,
wow, I'm happy about that.
Yeah. I will never ever forget this kind of feeling and this kind of occasion. I will never ever forget in my life this kind of occasion. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, I have the last question, sir.
Okay.
Yeah,
that's cool.
Yeah. So can we learn, spoken language without learning English grammar? Yes, this is common, question from other English learner. Yeah.
Yeah. So to ask is, can we learn without? Yes.
Can we learn spoken language without learning grammar? Because most of the English learner, they have been learning English grammar for a long time, maybe 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, but they couldn't speak English. When they speak English, they have a lot of pauses and some kind of hesitation, and maybe they make a lot of hesitation when they were speaking. So but on the other hand, just like international school student, they can speak English really well but without learning grammar. So I cannot that thing,
That's for sure.
So what is your opinion on that thing? What are your perspective on that question?
Okay. So like for me myself, I used to learn in that way, because in my first 3 years that I mastered English, so I didn't know even verb to be, I didn't know even present simple, some kind of, but I could speak English, but I could work with English native speaker. I become an English tour guide, and I have a lot of English friends. So that's amazing, because I didn't know even about verb to be. So, but that is got its own advantage, is like you learn a lot of vocabularies and listen a lot from YouTube and try to copy the sentences or the phrases that they use in each situation. And yeah. But I don't suggest to learn in that way, because the best way is you have to learn at the same time between grammar and because grammar can help you a lot to express yourself correctly. Like if you want to say something in the past, you have to say the correct verb, correct tenses, so that will help the listener to understand you better, and also could help you to save a lot of time to learn. Like example, if you learn the comparative, some kind of, you understand the rule of it, so it helps you to learn a lot of that kind of phrases about comparative and the other things. So my recommendation is you should learn at the same time, I guess, but first, so please, like I just said in the previous question, you have to listen first, then after listen you have to speak, like try to copy what you are listening. After you can speak, go to reading. So writing, the last one, I mean the grammar, you have to learn at last. Like if you don't speak English, that you go straight to grammar, that's boring. And if you go to the class, you even don't know what is English. They go, you ask you present simple. So how can I understand present simple? Because I didn't know English before. So yeah. What you have to learn is you go to class, and the first time you say how to say hello, how are you, what's your name, and try to copy those sentences. After you can speak a little bit, that's go to grammar, is the as the last part. But absolutely, so grammars can help you to express yourself correctly, and it's very benefit if you want to learn in the higher level of English units. Your grammar must be good, especially if you go to the IELTS exam or some kind of international exam. So you need to be correct in grammar. So that's my
you problem. Mean we shouldn't learn grammar for the first stage of
so we should learn to listening first, then learn to speak, learn vocabulary. Grammar just the last, after you can speak English very like in the intermediate level, I guess you can learn grammar later.
Wow.
Just do it later.
Okay, sir. I really wanted to know, when I was learning English, studying last year, I couldn't decide, properly, just like, should I learn grammar or should I learn, listening first? But I decided to make only listening all the time.
Yeah, that's now. Right, man.
But, without learning grammar textbook, I can speak English. Most of the time, I can speak English, correct grammar tests.
Uh-huh.
So, yeah.
Yeah, so you should do grammar as the last skill, I guess.
Thank you very much, sir. I have these five questions. So I already asked you a question. So if you have any question for me, so you can also ask me just like your student, and I will be answering you like my teachers.
So that how do many students speak English there in your country?
You mean percentage of
In general, people do they speak English?
Probably, maybe I really don't know, statistics, data. I guess maybe 10% of, our people can speak English,
So do they teach English at school?
In the school, government school, teachers are teaching English, but the way that they are teaching is like just like academic English. So they only teach how to write and how to read. That's it. No listening. Speaking. That's why even if they are graduate with English degree, but they couldn't speak English like just like intermediate level English student.
That's right. But what about university there? Do the students have to learn English, and do they speak a lot of English university?
I don't think so. I have so many students, who got, bachelor degree with English from, university, but they can't speak English. They can write properly, but their reading, their writing is super, super good, it's really nice, but they can't speak English.
That I think is kind of the norm, even in my country or in Vietnam. I used to live there before. Or in Thailand, I've been there a couple of times. Or in Cambodia, I went there once. I guess that is kind of the norm. So it's happened everywhere.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So Thank you so much, sir. And before we leave, you leave our program, so I will tell you in Lao for, you know, goodbye. So how can I say, you know, goodbye in Lao?
Khop chai. Goodbye. Actually, we use bye bye. Yeah, bye bye. Bye bye. It's quite similar to English.
Oh, is
it? You can say bye bye.
Yeah, but and see you later. It's me, Li Pong Khan Mai.
Leo Pop Khan Mai.
Oh, Leo Pop Khan Mai.
Leo Pop Khan Mai. What about your language? How to say that? How to say thank you in your language?
Jesu Timare.
Pardon? Speak slowly.
Jesu Timare.
Jesu
Timare.
Pardon? Jesu.
Jesu Timare.
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 Yeah, you really nice.
Jesus Tembare.
Yeah, Jesus Tembare.
Thank you. Okay,
see you later. See you later, sir.
Okay, see you later.
I hope to see you again. So I really need your permission. Can I use this video to post in my YouTube channel?
Sure.
Do you have YouTube channel, sir?
Yes, for sure. That's name similar to my Facebook page name.
So I will mention your YouTube channel in the description box.
Yeah, for sure. Okay.
Thank you so much.
Thank you too. Thank you too.
Bye.
Have a good day. Bye.
Same to you, sir.
Bye.